Hey, what's up, everybody?
What's up, man?
First of all, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you to AJ for the invitation. This is like technically my second real clinic, so I'm kind of new to this thing. But me and AJ have been in constant communication since June. We actually come. I have a love for this area because y'all just good people here. 757 is really good people, and 804 too. but I didn't want to not be here. I wanted to be here. By AJ's request, he wanted me to not say anything, just sit down and play. And I feel good. I feel really good. So AJ, thank you for being here. And I pray that God gives you back.
Amen. Amen.
What you lost this year.
Amen.
I pray for literally a table turn for your 2018.
Amen.
For real.
Amen.
Just like AJ, I have a heart for music and musicianship. And some things are really amazing that I see and that I hear and that I experience. And other things are kind of heartbreaking. And I thank AJ for what he did. And I thank Matt and Jaquan and even Justin because they really dove into the things that are disheartening. And a lot of times, we're more like this culture, this YouTube, millennial generation, social media, we're more so like involved with being the best, most killing, most fastest, most paid musician in the world. And there's nothing wrong with that dream or that goal. The problem is, when your aspiration becomes greed. And it's become greed. I was talking to a young friend of mine. He's like, who's like a mentee to me? And he literally spends his day on live. Instagram live, Facebook live. All the other lives there are. And I asked him, like, why do you do this? He was like, because I'm trying to show everybody what I got. And I'm like, when are you going to sit down and work on you? Like, beyond what you're trying to show everybody else, when are you going to work on you? Because to Justin's point, it don't matter how great you get. If you are horrible, you will fail. You know what I'm saying? Somebody said outside, you're bound to drown. Like, for real, you really are bound to drown. So I think it's dope that we've talked about a lot of those bound to drown symptoms that are plaguing our generation. What I want to talk about, what I want to do today is just talk about my journey in the last 4 years. My journey in the last 4 years have changed drastically because the things that I prayed for and I spoke out of my mouth have literally come to life. So I've gone beyond, the Bible says, one man plants, another man waters, but God gives the increase. I'm beyond planting and watering in this season of my life. I don't say that arrogantly either. Please don't misunderstand what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, I've asked God for a certain thing, and now I've gotten to a place where I am doing the certain thing that I asked God to perform in my life. And what we don't want to really deal with in a lot of times is the process from thinking it, speaking it, declaring it, and living it. And I don't mean like living in holiness. That's not what I mean. I mean, I want to play on stages in arenas. And then you find yourself on a stage in an arena. There's a process from that time that you speak that and the time that you actually get on stage to do it. And nowadays, we're spending more time forcing ourselves on the stage and not allowing the process to get us ready for the stage. So when we get the call to go on stage, we are prepared to be on stage. You know what I'm saying? And I don't want to talk a whole lot, but I do want us to dive into the process, because the process is important. I love Ronald Brewer. I love Vinny Caliuta. I love Steve Gadd. I love Joel Smith. I love Chris Johnson. I love Aaron Spears. I love Jamal Moore. But a lot of times when we are, thank you, brother, when we see them and we admire them, we don't understand what happened to them to get them to where they are now. So what we're doing is mimicking where they are, but not preparing the way they prepared. And what happens is we wonder why we aren't there. And the answer is we aren't there because we aren't going through the process. And I'm only saying this because I went through the process in college, Berklee College of Music. I went to Berklee College of Music in 2008. From 2008 to 2012, my life changed drastically. I mean, I wanted to be married to a whole nother person and play drums for whosoever will at any cost, leave my church behind, make millions and conjillions of dollars, and not serve or do what I'm doing now. 2008, I went. 2009, I broke up with her. 2010, I hated school. 2011, I called my parents and said, I'm getting out of here. I'm packing my bags. I'm dropping out. When I made the conscious decision to not drop out, and I lived my final year of college, was when I saw how stupid 2011 and 2010, 2009 I was. And how unprepared I was to live what I actually wanted to live. I was unprepared. And in 2010, 2011 was when we did the Michael Jackson tribute. And that was time for me for learning. If I never met Derek Cobbs, I wouldn't be a producer. If I never met Darian Javon, I wouldn't understand musicality from the other side of the track. Y'all feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And it's dope. Me and Brandon and Ramon were talking while Justin was up. He was talking about playing shout music. Because I was at Kingdom Week. I was there two Tuesdays ago. And they were playing shout music. And I was like, man, this is incredible. This is East Coast shouting. This is East Coast stylistic shout music. And Brandon's like, yeah, man, they was bumping. I was like, yeah, they was bumping. I talked to my boy Devin. I was like, man, y'all was playing some music. Y'all was killing, blah, blah, blah. And I was sat there, I said to myself, they weren't playing East Coast. They was playing Love Fellowship. Mm-hmm. And that's a whole nother thing. Yep. But if I'm more busy trying to play cymbals and chops and just play shout music and not really understanding, to Justin's words, the sound of that house, I can't get it. Because, and it's not, I promise you, I said I wasn't going to talk. Justin, your spirit is on me. I feel you. It's not that we are incapable. Mm-hmm. This generation is the most capable generation by far. And literally seems like as the generations go, the capability grows at a younger age. Like, what's the little kid that be playing the bass?
Yeah.
He was playing the Red Hands, No Way. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I still don't believe that's him.
Yeah.
I'm like, that can't be that kid playing bass at 5 years old like that. It's impossible. And they're like, yo, B, that's really him. You know what I'm saying? So it's not a thing of incapability. It's a thing of our focus is not prioritizing the right things. And what I want to talk to us about today is when you go through the process will teach you the priority of focus. Once you understand the priority of focus is when you start the process of preparation to get you to the place where you want to be. Aaron Spears is a mentor to me. He told me when he was rehearsing for Usher, at age 27, 28, at age 28, stop. Let's start there. How many of us are 18 and under? Raise your hand. How many of us 21 and under? Raise your hand. If you're under 21, raise your hand. Keep your hands high. You're not 21? You're older than 21? I'm about to say, good God Almighty. How many of us 25 and under? Guess what? None of y'all knew who Aaron Spears was at your age. Think about it. You didn't know who Aaron Spears was at your age. Why are you trying to be Vinny Calhuda at your age? You didn't know Aaron Spears when you were how old? When Aaron Spears was your age, nobody knew him. Let me not be literal. It's not nobody. The masses didn't know him as we know him now. You understand what I'm saying? We're rushing a process to get to a place that most of the idols that we look at weren't there till after the age that we are currently. Yeah. We try and be 18 playing for Chris Brown. Gerald is 40 what? And you 18 trying to play for Chris Brown. Why? You know what I'm saying? You will get there. Now, there are anomalies to the story. There's Tony Royster who did Common Ground at 9.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nothing you can do about that. I mean, he was playing next to Dennis Chambers. I mean, do any of us want to do that in Dennis Chambers' prime? No. I mean, let's call a spade a spade. You know what I'm saying? None of us want to do that. So there are anomalies to the story in every case. But the moral of what I'm trying to say is we're rushing through the process. And there is time for you to accomplish what God has spoken over your life. Not what you want God to have happen in your life. There is time for that. Because if he spoke it, he cannot lie. He is his word, and his word is him. Amen?
Amen.
So, 2012, I graduate. 2010, I meet my illustrious wife right there. Can you stand with all your beauty, please? Yes, you're amazing. Thank you for being here. I want to honor you. Thank you. You can sit down. That's so good. I want to honor my wife. Now, for all y'all who don't want to be married, let me tell you, when I made the decision to marry her, my life changed as well.
Amen.
I ain't going to lie to you about that one bit. The Bible says, he who findeth a wife findeth a good thing, comma, and obtains favor. You want to get a gig? Find a wife. Now, make sure she's the one for you, because that favor will turn into a nightmare fast. Don't rush it. Find her. Consult God. Make sure that's her. But, sorry, I'm off on a tangent. So, I met my wife in 2010. Played a recording. Blah, blah, blah. So forth and so on. I wanted to leave school. In that time, 2008 to 2012, I learned many genres of music. I learned Latin. I learned Brazilian. I learned samba. I learned how to swing. I learned the difference between bebop. I learned what was different between Elvin Jones and Buddy Rich. What was the difference between Papa Joe Jones and Philly Joe Jones. And I learned the difference between Max Roach and Gene Krupa. And I understand how Carter Buford can make so much money playing all those parts and how Steve Gadd is the most sampled drummer in all the world. Y'all all looking at me like, who are half those people you just spoke about? You know what I'm saying? I learned that John Bonham, listed on the greats from top to bottom, number one rock drummer in all the world. Ringo Starr was playing John Bonham. The Beatles heard the Rolling Stones and ran. The Rolling Stones heard black music and ran. But we can't get on stage with Bruce Springsteen and not know that knowledge. Because if Bruce is like, I want to hear John Bonham feels, you'd be like, okay, cool. Bearden, who was Michael Jackson's MD for This Is It. Michael Bearden tells me a story of one of the most phenomenal keyboard players in the world, who we all know. I will not say his name. He was in the room rehearsing for Beyonce. In the room rehearsing for Beyonce. Playing the keyboards and everything. Playing the keyboards. Smashing. Right? They're like, man, we're about to make it. We're going to go far in all the world. This is going to be amazing. Best tour of all time. It's time for Beyonce to come to rehearsal. Everybody ready? Yeah. Start the click. Hey, man, what's wrong? Buddy. Yo. He was starstruck by Beyonce, falls out, passes out, hits the ground, boom. They said by the time they got him back to consciousness, his flight was booked to go home. Can you imagine that? I mean, this ain't no slouch neither. I mean, this is a keyboard player. If we walked him in here right now and told him to stop playing, he would literally, I mean, even the lights will start moving. It's how good he is. And when Beyonce walked in the door, hits the ground. Why am I saying all this? What I'm saying to you is, he's amazing. Still is, was back then. Was that where he was supposed to be at that time? Because most people, once you get the consciousness that I got this call to play for Beyonce, I'm good. He probably never seen Beyonce before. Never seen a woman like of that kind of beauty, of that kind of stature. And she walked in and he was like, oh my God, that's Beyonce. And everything that I have in my mind is gone. I can't play a thing. And you can't play for Beyonce and be starstruck because you might be at a show and Jay-Z might show up. When Jay-Z shows up, that means Dame Dash might be with him. If Dame Dash is with him, Diddy might show up at the New York show. And if Diddy don't show up at the New York show, Barry Gordy might come to the Detroit show. Barry Gordy doesn't come to the Detroit show, Stevie Wonder may come to the Detroit show. If you don't go to the LA show, you might see Chick Corea. All because you're playing for B. And if you're not prepared for that stuff, you're going to hit the ground. You're going to hit the ground. So, I learned all these different genres. I learned country, pop, rock. It was one of the genres. It was the dumbest class I took. I took it just to get an A. I knew the teacher would give me an A because I'm thinking it's simple. Just play the rock beat. And to a point, that was it. To a point. I mean, some beats you. But to the point, you're playing one, three, and that's it. To the point. I left that class, got the A, told the teacher, so long, bye-bye, get out of my face, see you on the flip, right? 2014, I get the call to fill in for Daughtry. Now that's 5 years almost of time that's passed of me playing that stuff. And the blueprint that I had was not necessarily rock, pop, country. The blueprint was more so like pop, new age, contemporary. I couldn't meet that. I played what I knew. Not only did I play the beat, but when it got time for me to be able to establish who I am, I changed the tones of the drums. Matt was talking earlier about some of us going to R&B gigs and country gigs and pop gigs. Y'all got snares ready for a shout box. Nah, Doc. You ain't hearing no snares on rock records. What's the last Willie Nelson record you heard with a snare like this? What's the last King of Leon record you heard with a snare like this? You ain't hearing it. Those are the modes of preparation. So I get to there. I get afforded the job to play for this person, for Daughtry or whatever. And they're like, all right, cool. Now, we want to go back away from the live show and we want to play the records again. We want to make sure that we're playing the records. I'm like, all right, cool. You know, we can play records all day. Nah, Doc. What's the pattern of the song? Oh, okay, the pattern. Yeah, what is the drums playing on the record? Oh, okay, the drums are playing this. But what's all that other stuff? Oh, that's programming. That ain't your job. Your job is to play the drum part. Okay, cool, I got it. So when I play my part and the programmer plays its part, it sounds like this. Yeah, but that hi-hat opens in the programmer. Don't worry about it. You play your part. You know what I mean? So I had to go in there and play my part. Then I hear this weird sound in my ears.
Metronome.
That's who?
Metronome.
That's metronome, also known as the click. Drummers, bass players, keyboards, keyboard players, guitar players, xylophone players, singers, anybody who makes music, your job is to marry that click. If you ain't marrying a click, you're not gonna work.
Yeah.
This is stuff that y'all don't hear when you see your favorites playing. Straight up. They don't tell you that there's a click and you gotta know the countings of the click. Ain't no
1, 2, 3.
Ain't that. It's coo, 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 coo. Miss that if you want to. Guess where you going?
Home.
On your way home. And don't get me wrong, it's dope that we got NPCs and Ableton and it's dope. I love it. I don't want to play a gig without it. But if I have to play JJ's set without loops, I can. And JJ comes back to me and be like, yo, how was the gig? He'd be like, it was rough. Why was it so rough? They didn't really know the music. They didn't really play it right. What do you mean? Oh, you know, we got to know Reason of Fear. You know, at the 3, 3, 4, 5. I'm like, yeah. He's like, And the drummer just starts chopping all over the place. I'm like, what you mean? He's like, you know, he's like. The problem is, we're taking the liberty to go forth and beyond without knowing the form of the song.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean? So what's happening is, which isn't necessarily a bad thing that we have the facility and the ability. The bad thing is that the facility and the ability is taking precedence over the song. And the song is key. Let me tell you. When we did JJ's record, right? Me, RC, Sean Walters, Dre Jones, Jerome Kirkland, we in there coming up with all the hits. I mean, we rehearsing the hits. I mean, we did Sunday night at 8, Monday at 12, Tuesday at 1, Wednesday at 11, Thursday, we'll take a break. Friday, we'll come back after our gigs late night. I mean, it was literally one Sunday night. We went from 8. And when we got out, the sun was coming up for the next morning. All to play Jesus Reigns. Fantastic. That song ain't nominated for a Grammy. We spent literally an hour on You Deserve It. Literally an hour, because we didn't care. Everybody got it? 4145. Everybody good? Yeah. Oh, we should put a line in it. All right, let's. Ba-da-da. Okay, what's the intro gonna be? Let me make the intro the chorus. Cause let's move on. Let's move on to the bump. Guess what we playing every single night? You deserve it. Trust me, I used to be you when the guys used to tell me, yo man, Poppy get you the paper. I'd be like, man, shut up. I'm here to tell you, the pocket will get you paper. Pocket will get you paper. Once you've established the pocket, you get your check. Then when the musician's corner with the Facebook lives and all that is popping, and they let you go, take off. But the priority is the paper and the pocket. Ain't no pocket, ain't no paper. If there ain't no paper, 9 times out of 10, cause it ain't no pocket.
Uh-oh.
I cannot stress that enough. And I know sometimes we see, like, we hear different records, we hear different people playing, and we're like, you, that's killing. But in hindsight, Calvin can do what he does because he's established a pocket. I was listening to Favor of God by James Fortune over on the way. I can't tell you what the intro was, but I can tell you what that groove is. And it's in my heart. The niggas is, I'm sorry Pat, because they are smashing. Sorry, I got comfortable. I'm sorry Pat, please forgive me. Because they are smashing. Alright, so where do we go from here? I want to play some more. Y'all tell me, y'all want to hear a doctor song?
Yes, sir.
Alright, yeah, let me Let me talk. Let me play some pocket. Pocket consists of a few things. Pocket consists of playing the pattern and understanding your position enough so that whatever you play does not throw off anyone else. Those are the elements of pocket. Playing the pattern, knowing your position so that what you play does not throw off anybody else, including the singers. Including the singers. If you can do that, you'll work forever. This song is going to be a little bit boring, but it's the highest paid gig that I have. It paid for my wedding. I just want to just put that out there. It's the most boring thing I play. But
paid for the wedding.
It paid for my wedding.
Pocket, bring the paper.
It bought me my house. It gives me the insurance that we talked about earlier that I don't pay for. I'm just trying to put it in a little bit of, and we're going to talk about that. Because we try to make a living out of playing gospel music, and gospel music ain't meant for you to make a living out of. We'll talk about that.
She's watching taxi driver. Watching the clowns roll by and they spell her name. Let
Pocket paper.
Now, oh, sorry.
That Dr. song and No Reason to Fear are, I want to play those first because I want to talk about patterns. Patterns are important in playing gospel, in playing R&B, playing pop, playing country, playing rock. If you want to be a drummer and you want to work, you got to play the pattern. Me and Brandon were talking because when Justin brought up Joel Smith, and we think about Thank You Lord, there's a distinct drum beat. It's very distinct. And what happens is a lot of drummers aren't playing it. And I just, it crawls my skin when I hear a drummer play this. I mean, they play Blessed, Oh Give Thanks, Thank You Lord, This Is The Day. I mean, it's all four on the floor. But that's him and his band. To Justin's point, when you go to AIM, and I was saying, AJ, next year, if you bring us back, let the clinicians play together.
Right.
I don't want to sound like I'm coming down to you, sorry. Have the clinicians play together. Because then they have to talk about their mindset and their mobility in the arena of which it's uncomfortable. I mean, I've practiced these songs. I can play these songs backwards. But I ain't played with Justin that many times, and I never played with Matt. So when me and Matt got to sit down, when me, Matt, and Justin got to sit down and play This Is The Day.
Should do it now.
Y'all want to do it now?
Yeah.
All right, let's play.
Yeah.
Let's play something different though. Let's play the musician offering song.
Come on, man.
Let's play either. No, I just want to praise you.
I just want to praise you.
Now I'm not gonna say what my mentality is until after. Prophet Khan, can you come play under with us? Can you please come play organ with this? Come on. Y'all give it up for Prophet.
Go ahead.
That's my man. That's my man. Right there.
Go ahead, Prophet. Prophet.
What key we? The original is B flat or is it F? What's the original? F?
Alright,
we can go F. I would be like, let's play this on an A, but I'm in A. That's so dumb.
All right, y'all ready?
It don't matter, man. All
right, guys. We can do it. All right, so what? All right, F it is. Okay. Now, this is the key to Justin's point. Actually, just look at what they're doing. They're communicating. It's the key. Communication is the key. We don't know what we're going to play until someone says, this is what we're going to do. Guys, intro. Thank you, Jesus, for blessing me Walk down, da, da, five. I just wanna pray. That's how we'll start. Okay? Yep. Thank you, Jesus. 3, 6, 2, 5. Yep. Ready? 1, 2,
teach us, sir.
Because all of us are MDs in some capacity. So we all play it differently. So we have to talk the musician language. 5, 3, 6, 2. Does everyone know what that is?
Yes, sir.
Be honest. Does everyone know what that is? No. Okay. This is the number system based off of the major scale. Correct me if I'm wrong, Matt.
There.
Now what happens is, if we're in a minor key, it's not the same. So if you say 3 to musicians and we in a minor key,
I'm going to the 3 and major.
He's gonna go to 3 and major.
Right.
So I have to talk a whole other language to him at that point.
Call out notes.
Yeah, you gotta start calling out notes at that point. Which, if any drummer is the MD of that situation, and you don't have like perfect pitch, or you're not cool, defer to the keyboard player. It's okay. It's okay. Defer. Go ahead. Go ahead. Tell him.
Go ahead, man.
Tell him. So, number system. Do, 1. Re, 2. Mi, 3. Fa, 4. Sol, la, ti. Do is either 8 or 1, however you want. They're the octave of the first two, of 1. So when we be like, 3, 3, 4, 5, 3, 3, 4, 5, so we're just talking the major scale. We're just telling them what to play. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. We're just talking the major scale. That's it. Now, what happens is, once you start understanding gospel music, and which is really derivative of like blues and jazz put together, you start understanding your passing, your passes. So you have 2, 5, 1s, 7, 3, 6, which is, let's talk history, which is the code that slaves would sing back in the day. Whole nother thing for a whole nother day. But am I right, Matt? Am I lying?
You're there.
Yeah. So the reason why, and the thing is, most, if not all, 99% of all Negro spirituals, actually 100% of all Negro spirituals are written in black keys. Mm-hmm. Written in black keys because all the keys are black notes. Mm-hmm. Each and every one of them. If you find one that's white, like Amazing Grace, it's not a Negro spiritual.
Wow, I never knew that.
Because you can't play it all blacks.
Never knew that. That's good.
You can't play it in all blacks. You will be wrong. Should we try?
Go ahead. Teach us.
Amazing one. All blacks.
Still on black.
All blacks.
I'd be dead.
All blacks.
Still on blacks.
All blacks.
Shut up, man.
All blacks.
That's dope.
That's how you know it's real.
Yeah. Perfect.
You feel me?
That's good.
So that's that. So patterns. Just want to praise you. We know the song. Me, I'll talk from the drummer's perspective. I was listening distinctively to two people. Whoever was leading the melody and Justin. Whoever was leading the melody, because the melody was telling me where we are in the song. And if I can be frank, I'm a very straight shooter. That's what happened on This Is The Day. That's why I failed, because no one was playing the melody of where they were. So nobody knew where they were. They were all singing it in their heads, but no one was taking the forward step, the initiative to play the melody. Bum bum da da. That way we all know where we are. But when Justin was up, he was like, all right, this is day in E flat. Everyone was just like, ba da 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 da. If you have recollection of the song, cool. Justin's a church boy. I mean, he can play This Is The Day in any key and be fine. But if I'm just starting out in Kojic Church because the drummer couldn't be there and I got to fill in, and I don't know This Is The Day. Whoa. Now we're talking a whole other issue. And what happens is Bishop gets upset because that drummer should know This Is The Day because 90% of his band is sitting up there playing. Are you so important? Are you that invested in where you play that you can lead others around you? If you are, you're ready. If you cannot, you're not ready.
Mm-hmm.
I know it's a tough reality. I'll be honest. I took on playing for MDN for JJ because it was like an opportunity for me. I was not ready to MD. I went through 6 bands before I got to the band that we have currently. I mean, 6 of them. And because it just weren't the right gel. Some people couldn't make flights on time. Other people didn't have passports. Some people didn't know how to set up tracks. Some people couldn't play an E. You can't play for JJ if you can't play an E. He is exalted as an E. Grateful is an E. We moved, what's the name, from E to E flat because he has too many songs in E. You Deserve It was in F sharp, and we just all ran around the church because we said it's not an E, it's a Bible, Jay. You know what I'm saying? How many of y'all have passports, working passports, not expired passports? Get a passport. Y'all want, all right. Story, true story. I was laying in my bed. It was like 8:00 in the morning. Trent Phillips texts me, "Hey man, wake up, call me right now." Everybody know who Trent Phillips is, right? No, okay, cool. Okay. You're not ready. I hate to break it that way. I told you I'm a straight shooter. I'm sorry. You can't know Mike Burrell and not know Jason White. You can't know Jason White, not know Kevin Barr. You can't know Aaron Lindsay and not know Trent Phillips. Honestly. So we'll just keep going up. Wake up, call me immediately. Okay. Anybody, my wife knows I don't wake up before 10. If you call me before 10, you ain't getting me. It's just not happening. I believe that that's ungodly to call somebody before 10 o'clock. It's very ungodly. I don't do it. So he called me. He was like, yo, do you have a passport? Yes. Can you go to Dominica with Pastor Donnie in 2 weeks? Mm-hmm. Sure can. Cool. Give me 5 minutes. 5 minutes later comes 20 songs. Yeah, man, you need to learn all these. Cool. Sitting down playing the drums a week later. Yo, man, what's the set list? There is no set list. What he feels, he will sing. Huh? What he feels, he will sing. All right, cool. Travel to Dominica, and Trent's not even on that gig. We have Titus Robertson playing keys, Natalie Reagan's playing, Maurice Fitzgerald's playing bass, and Joey Wolfork is playing guitar. So Pastor Donnie's like, you know my music? I'm like, sure do, buddy. He was like, okay, we'll see. So we get the drums together, pop, 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 sing, 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 wah, 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 boom, 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 boom. Now, I'm gonna be honest, I was shaking in my boots because that's Maurice Fitzgerald that I'm playing next to, who is the godfather of gospel bass, in my opinion. How can I be playing next to Maurice Fitzgerald? Impossible. Maurice is played by the greatest of drummers. He's played next to Calvin Rogers, Liddell Abrams. He's played next to Joel Smith. I mean, he's played next to Dana Davis. I mean, he's played next to Jeff Davis. He's played next to everybody. Why am I on these drums? So, because I got a passport. So we in soundcheck, Pastor Donnie's like, I mean, the whole 20 songs, the whole list. I mean, Days of Elijah. I'm walking in authority. Hail Jesus, you're my king. Only you are holy. We fall down. Stand. How great is our God is in the settlers, but it's an arrangement that they do themselves. You console me once more and again is on that record. Caribbean Melody, Medley is on that record. I came for deliverance. Deliverance I receive is on that record. I mean, it's on that list of songs. I gotta do it. And so Pastor Donnie's like, hey, yo, let's do Great I Am. Great I Am, 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 Great I Am. That's not on the list.
That's full of his.
And I'm like, Great I Am is ba 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 da ba da ba 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 da ba ba da ba 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 da ba 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 da ba da ba ba. You are. That's going to the van. He's like, yeah, let's start there. I'm like, Titus, Great I Am ain't on the list. He's like, I know. You better play it. So I'm like, how's that possible, bro? He was like, I don't know, you better figure it out. I was faking the funk. I knew that song. Didn't know it because my church sang it. Didn't know it because I played it on a prior gig. I knew it because I went and learned it. Just in case, because when Trent said there is no set list, that means anything in this man's repertoire is up for game. And just because it's not on the list doesn't mean I ain't supposed to know it. And I played it pretty well. I was like, yeah, gotcha. He was like, all right, cool. And I'm a church kid. I mean, I grew up Baptist. I'm non-denominational now. But we got like some paper or something. I need your help. Yep. Happens to me all the time, man. So I'm used to those packs. I'm sorry. Take that. I love you. So it's like I faked the funk. I knew the song. He was like, all right, cool. You think you bad, ain't you? I'm like, no, I'm not bad. Go ahead. Let's just do something else on the set list. He was like, He was like, trusting in you. played drums with that long chop in the beginning. Wait, I'm in a Koji church. I don't know who Josh Mayfield is.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay, I'm going to say, man, y'all should be ashamed of yourselves. I got to play that. He's like, yeah, from the top. That's the. All right. Here we go. Played it down. He was like, okay, you can play some chops too, huh? All right. Higher. Higher? He said, yeah, it hasn't been released yet. Start it. My eyes are glued to Titus. You gotta talk me through this song, because I don't know it. He was like, all right, cool. It starts with a little Latin beat in the first verse, and then the intro is church, just like Great I Am. When we come out to the pre-chorus of the first verse, go out of the Latin, go straight to two and four on the snare. We come out of that, go back to the intro. The first verse, the second verse are exactly the same. When you go to the bridge, go back to the Latin thing, back to the Latin beat on the bell of the ride, though, but make sure you're playing the tom on hit two. Cool? I'll get you for the rest of there. Goes back to the church. All right, cool. Cool. 1, 2, 3, 4. You're good. Keep playing. You're good. That's right. Pastor Donnie's looking at me like, hey, you're about to fail. And I'm looking at him. I'm looking at him and Titus like, I'm about to fail. Titus, first verse. 1, 2, 3. Latin beat. Someone's raising their hands like, yeah, I know it. Cool. Who understands song form? Raise your hand. Oh, not half the hands done gone down all of a sudden. All right, what's the first verse to How Great Is Our God? Keep going. Good job. How many of us legitimately knew that? Okay, excuse me. Who knows song form? Who knows Perfect Peace by Pringle? Keith Pringle. Who knows that? Okay, everybody pull out your cell phones. Pull out your cell phones. Listen, I'm gonna get y'all right. We don't gotta play no more drums. I'm gonna teach y'all to be good, yeah? I'll keep you in perfect peace. See, y'all ready? Y'all ready? Stayed on the my. Now, Marvin Sapp on Be Exalted record. Aaron Lindsay, Maurice Fitzgerald, Calvin Rogers. You want to know how to play song form? That's the song to do it.
Yeah.
It's not any more plain than that. Perfect Peace, Marvin Sapp on the Be Exalted record. Did everybody see the Tupac movie?
Yeah.
That was so random.
Y'all wanna be musicians? Okay. Graphic language. I get it. Okay. Christians, I get it. Okay, cool. No problem. We here. When Tupac got shot, when Tupac got shot, Perfect Peace, that's the song. Y'all hear the man, don't keep you in perfect peace. Yeah, that's perfect peace. Song form, all day long. song form. Woo! Ricky Diller, Take Me Back record. Ricky Diller, Take Me Back record. They playing at William A. Ellis' church, First Apostolic Church of God in Chicago, Illinois. Calvin is playing 8, 10, 12, 14. On that record. Is it 16 or 14? That's it. 10, 12, 14. I'm sorry. 10, 12, 14 on that record. Song form. He plays There Is No Way. Like a boss. Like a boss. Terry Baker fans? Oh, my Lord Jesus, help me. Help me, Jesus. No, it's okay. Listen, the key to getting ready is knowing who's already ready. That's the most smartest thing I've said all night. Thank you. The key to being ready is knowing who is already ready. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Y'all don't like Terry Baker and y'all be playing Hosanna every Palm Sunday? Absolutely. Y'all can't be, y'all know. Y'all be doing that. Y'all don't know that's Terry Baker? My Lord. Yeah. Mike Robinson playing at Triton? My God, today. Okay. My Lord. Okay, cool. Please don't do that. Okay, y'all like Presence of the Lord Is Here by Byron Cage, right? That's Terry Baker playing drums. Top, yes sir. Terry Baker is, he's living in Dallas now. I think he's originally from Louisville, right? Originally from Louisville. All right, y'all know Amber Baker, the girl who plays drums?
Yes.
That's her daddy. She went to school, she went to Berkeley with me. Amber Baker, her father is Terry Baker. Coming to you a little bit? Oh, it's like kind of, oh my God. Okay, so, that's a good question. So who do y'all listen to?
Michael Jackson.
Okay, good, let's stop right there. What record?
Thriller, Off the Wall, but I'm more actually a fan of his live performances with Jonathan Moffitt and Ricky Lawson. I studied them.
Nice, who played the records?
Jeff McCarl, somebody else. I know David Williams did session guitar on most of his albums.
Who played drums? Ooh. Ndugu played a few in the latter years. All right. John J.R. Robinson. All
right. John J.R. Robinson. Rock with you.
Y'all be doing gospel. How many of y'all do R&B gigs and y'all don't play gospel? No, y'all raise your hand. I walk down the aisle and say y'all lying. Matt asked, how many of y'all play secular gigs? Everybody raised their hand. He said, how many of y'all play secular gigs like gospel gigs? And nobody raised their hand. And I walked down the center aisle and said, y'all are lying. There's just no way. It's impossible. We ain't all studying them songs and we don't know who Terry Baker is. We ain't all studying them songs and we don't know John J.R. Robinson. That's no slight to you, buddy. You know what I'm saying? There's no way. Because it's simple. It's simplified. I mean...
Jesus. What's
the song with the time in the what's the song with the time in the chorus? Oh, it's Rock With You. Nobody plays that time. What's the song?
Billie Jean.
No. Thank you. It's Billie Jean. Thank you. Thank you. I be hearing people butcher that song. I mean, I'm just tearing up. Pattern, gentlemen, ladies, patterns. For the ladies who are singers, I wish I could sing like Kim Burrell and Marvin Winans. I wish I could. Sometimes we try to do that and we get so far beyond the melody that the keyboard player is lost. You know what I mean? And yes, sir. Oh, thank you, doctor. Don't you stop me about right around this church. It's Kojic Church. You just got to play the shot at 160. This 157 is not happening. That's okay. Okay. So, patterns. So, when we did No Reason to Fear, when we did No Reason to Fear, we did that song with no programming. No programming was added. So what y'all hear with the and all the programming and stuff, that's in No Reason to Fear. None of that was there when we recorded that song. Oh, do y'all know what programming is? I'm really being, listen, sometimes you gotta break down. I'm programming. No, okay. Programming is the sounds and the bells and whistles that you hear a part of a song. Okay, y'all, AJ said y'all call them stems. Backing tracks. Yeah, but when you hear a song, you don't know. Sometimes you hear a song, you don't know what is what. Sometimes you just don't know. On No Reason to Fear, you have to really listen to really understand what the drums are doing on that song, because we purposely mixed it with the drums in the back. Be the Pilot, only song I ever do that, because I'm a drummer. So I want the drums up front. God bless all of you. But so the drums are in the back. So when we originally recorded that song, there was nothing but my trusty friend. That was it. So when I'm literally playing, who has the final say? Jehovah has the final say. That's me literally doing this with nothing else. And it's hard because sometimes you want to be like, I mean, listen, it gets the best of us. Sometimes we all want to do it. But when you're talking patterns, and you're talking building a, I'm kind of going into production mode now. When you're talking patterns and building a song, recording. Justin, you've been in sessions where they give you the song, and it's, everybody want to be a recording player in here? Everybody wants to record? Yeah? Okay, your job as a recording musician is to, one, listen and follow directions. Right. Two, do what you're told. Three, see the vision of the producer far beyond where you are. That is your job. If you can't do that, you're not going to work. That's why Calvin has all the work sewn up, because he does it better than anyone else. He can sit at the drums and the producer tell him, all right, I'm going for this. All right, this is the beat. Calvin's like, all right, cool. What are vocals doing? What you playing? Okay, that's what you playing. Cool. You talk about, you and Jeff did that, y'all. What you playing? Me and RC had our own rehearsals before we did JJ's record. Me and RC sat together, and this is how we gonna play. Me and Morgan did the same thing on the Blood Experience with Charles Butler. We sat together and played. The reason why Morgan is smacking like that on the Blood is because I told him, go. But I can't tell Morgan go, and Morgan's taking off, and the organ player is right behind him, chasing his coattail. He's wrong. He has to understand, my job right now is to play the chords. While Morgan is off to the races. Now, when we play live, we abandon all the rules, purposefully. Because I don't believe in rules when you're live. When you're live, it's God thing. Whatever happens in the moment, happens in the moment. Mistakes and all, I don't care about that. When you're cutting a record, it's different. Because you have to create music that will span your life. When I'm dead, you deserve it, will still continue to play. There's some things I hate about that song. None I can do about it now because it's out. I'm telling you. The only reason I'm telling y'all this is because I know some of us really care to be far along. These are the things that you don't hear on YouTube. When you're listening to Kaz and you listen to Ronald Bruner. When Ronald Bruner is in the studio with Stanley Clarke, Stanley's telling Ronald, play this. When Thomas is in the studio, was in the studio with Miles Volta, Thomas, play this. Then expand. But we hear the expansion and think that's the starting point, and it's not. That's not the starting point at all. Thank you. That's not the starting point whatsoever. Okay? So, pattern, pocket, paper.
Pattern, pocket, paper. Yes, sir.
Pattern, pocket, paper.
Baby.
Huh. If y'all ain't hear nothing else I said tonight, pattern, pocket, paper. Yes, sir.
I'm not a drummer, but patterns are important. So, I saw, how you broke it down from your last player. Did No Reason to Fear. Now, we've done that song here. Not here, but we've done it for our work is in there. And the way that it was played, that we played it, we tried to play it like a record, but you really can't come close to it. So how do you break down those patterns, or how do you know where to place certain stuff? How do you feel the momentum of the song about to shift so you can play the next pattern?
Are you talking from a bass perspective or a drum perspective?
Perspective.
Well, honestly, gotcha. Honestly speaking, for a drummer, that song is pretty self-explanatory on where the builds and the, for example, first verse, the intro is the intro. Now let's talk about a dynamic there. It's supposed to stop. Nothing is supposed to be ringing. It's not supposed to be this. It's also not this. It's not that either. Who has the final say? I'm out. Jehovah has the final say. Wait. All right. So we'll talk song form too. Song form is supposed to be played on every instrument. You're playing verses, choruses, pre-choruses, vamps, climaxes, endings, stops, everything. You are a part of that. All right, so first verse, I'm playing nothing. Repeat of the second verse. Let's build. Let's build a foundation. Final say, who has the final say? Jehovah has the final say. I have no reason to fear. We're in another part of the song. We should be established. That should be established. This is another part. You can't coast through sections of songs. It's supposed to feel different. Okay? I have no reason to fear. The Lord is my light. Boom, boom. The Lord is my light. Boom, boom, boom. Second verse, bum, 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 bum. Just like the first verse, but different. Who has the final say? Jehovah as my final. Did that whole one time, right? We're building higher. In the first verse, I added the foot. The second time around, this time I'm adding 2 and 4 on my snare. Cool, is everybody making sense? Along with everybody? We're going to another part of the song. I have no reason to fear. We're in a whole other part. Okay. Cool. Is this making sense to everybody?
Yep.
All right. Then when we go to the vamp, I have no reason to fear. Bum, bum, bum. I have no reason to fear. Bum, bum, bum. I have no reason to fear. Now, let me be honest. I added this foot in that song right there because the vocals were kind of shifting off the click, which is, you know, it's a vocal thing, and so they're going to shift. This is the way, this is what they do. This is, yeah, they're not thinking about rhythm because they're thinking about notes and words. So it's your job, drummers, to also help keep everybody in time. That's also your job. James Brown said, if I fall out of time because you're not doing your job. That's what James Brown said to his band. And he, if y'all saw the movie, did everybody see the James Brown movie? Let's just make sure, please. He looked at the organ and was like, what instrument is that? He's like, it's an organ. No, it's a drum. Why? Because your job is to keep everybody in time. What is this? It's a saxophone. No, it's a drum. All right, so I hope that makes sense. Now, when we get to the vamp, all right, so JJ is church. He's church first, everything else second. He's church first, everything else. Even when it's songwriting, he's church first, everything. He wants to get to church. If we don't get to, if we don't get to that, we ain't done our job. That's why the gig is played the way it's played. See, it sounds like we're just hauling off all the notes that we can find. That's not happening. We're building the intensity to get to a climactic point. At the same time, we're keeping the train moving because JJ doesn't like to stand still. You know what I mean? So I know y'all see us playing JJ. It's like, ooh, RC and Brandon are just taking off. That gig is built for bass and drums.
Right.
To literally keep the engine moving. Mm-hmm. And no singer, no preacher, no person with a mic wants to have accompaniment that's not continuously moving the engine along. It's your job to continuously move the engine. Mm-hmm. Cool, did that answer that question? So when we get to the vamp, it's this climactic point of getting to the engine. Now, if you're a church person, the climax is cymbals. I mean, it's called spade to spade. The climax is cymbals. You know what I mean? Even when we're in a bump, the climax is cymbals. That's why I don't understand we do first breakdown and we automatically in cymbals. No. The cymbals is when you get to the climactic place where literally, and Ramon said this earlier, playing shout music is a song now. It's musical. You're building with the unit. So sometimes you gotta tarry and walking and playing that walk until it gets in the house.
Yes, sir.
And when it gets in the house, then it's time to move. But sometimes you'll be like, bah, 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 and y'all look around, nobody dancing.
Nobody.
It's too early. It's too soon. It's too soon.
Too early.
Yeah. You call it victory way too soon. You gotta let that joint tarry in a little longer. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? You gotta let that joint tarry. Now, I'm gonna be honest, and this, I'm not playing. My shout music approach, I got it from that guy sitting right there. Brandon Taylor is where I got.
Yes.
Listen. Don't let anybody tell y'all different. If you playing this, that's Brandon Taylor. That's Brandon Taylor. Don't let nobody tell you different.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna tell you, it's Brandon Taylor.
Yep.
It's Brandon Taylor. Now he doing this. I'm putting that on the next record too. But that's Brandon Taylor. So I definitely want to give honor to that because that's his thing. All right. Anybody else got? Let me stop. Who has questions? All right, let's talk. Huh?
How do you develop when you're playing a groove and it's like one of them complicated grooves or pockets? How do you develop the independency and also keep that constant?
Practice. Literally. And I'm going to play the Blood of Jesus last before we leave. And that's a complicated pattern, the Charles Butler record. That's what it is. That's what it is. But the way that you build the independence is literally to continuously practice it. I know it's the most cliche answer I could ever give you, and I hate cliche answers, but that's really the truth. It's really, really, really the truth. The only way you can get your left hand is keep working it. You gotta keep working it. You literally gotta. Did I say that? Pause. Jesus. I know, I'm sorry. I was like, it hit me that I was like, Jesus. Alright, Jesus. Oh my God. You literally have to keep doing it. And I'm big on patterns, and I got that from Jamal Moore. We did our first Trinity record, and I went to Jamal's house to figure out a specific direction. He was like, yo, create a pattern. And don't be like, no, you know, and it's alright. My thing with gospel music is we've gotten so redundant, we ain't reaching nobody else because we're doing the same thing over and 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 over again.
True.
I mean, how many more songs do we need to hear 1, 6, 4, 5? I mean, I'm just, and then not in, who has phones out? We trying to take on somebody's sound that ain't even us. And we like, this is the sound of the new house. It was the sound of that era.
Yeah.
That era is past and gone. Let's create something else. But every record, we trying to be CCM.
Yeah,
thinking they got more oil than what was established before. Okay, I'm sorry. So, I encourage all of you to create the new sound. Create the new sound. I love Jeremy Haynes. I love Calvin Rogers. I love Terry Baker. I love Aaron Spears. But I'm Brandon. And can't nobody take Brandon away from me. And for the drummers, if we all keep playing like Calvin, Calvin gonna continue to work. Because we can't be Calvin. He is Calvin. So if we all keep playing, I mean, to the point we even starting to sit like him. We all playing pearl drums. We all went out and brought drum crafts. We all got bald heads. Why? And that has nothing. Listen, Calvin is the pioneer, one of the pioneers of my playing. Calvin is the pioneer of contemporary gospel drumming. But we keeping him in business by literally doing what he. Well, how? Let me approach it just like Calvin. Come on, y'all. Oh,
that's true.
Did I offend anybody? Hope I wasn't trying. I wasn't trying to be offensive. I'm just trying to tell you how to get there. Because if we just keep carbon copying, this is the air I breathe. We just keep carbon copying how great is our God. I mean, the church needs simple songs. No, they don't. They don't need simple songs. They need a new sound. They need for something fresh. It ain't anointed because you're stealing somebody else's anointing.
It's your own.
Get in your own thing and find your own sound. Come on. I mean, sorry. Let me sit down. So, play the drums that make you sound good. Establish the sound that makes you who you are. You know what I'm saying? If it's DW for you, play DW. the best drums ever created in God's world. If it's Zildjian for you, play Zildjian, the greatest cymbals ever created in God's world. If it's Remo, play Remo, the best percussion and heads God ever created. If you just want to be lackluster, that's okay. Somebody has to come in second at all times. Somebody has to come in second at all times. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, it's just it's in my heart to challenge the next generation to be who you are. Be you. Create you. I wish the young man was still here, because when he asked the question, like, I get jealous when I see other people. No need to get jealous. You are you. You are the best you ever. And if you're trying to be somebody else, you'll never be you. You'll be them. Or at least a horrible example of them. Be who you are. And I'm talking to you like this because it's passionate for me. You know what I mean? Because at the end of the day, they all want you to buy their cymbals.
Yeah.
They want you to buy their drums. They want you to buy their sticks. They want you to buy their pearl, their pedals, because it puts money in their pocket. And if you send them a DM on Instagram, they're not even answering you. Ask them to come to a clinic and hang. It's going to be $1,500.
Off top.
And you are just continuously trying to become something that has already proven to be successful. Great. Leave the success for them. Create your own success. Create your own success. That's the only way we will progress to a place. My journey is not like Brandon's journey. Brandon's journey is not like Matt's journey. Matt's journey is not like Justin's. Justin's not like AJ's. Nobody's journey is supposed to be the same. The only thing that's similar is we on the same race to get to the same place. That's the only thing. But it ain't given to the swift nor to the strong. It's given to the one that endures. Endures. Stay the course, young people. Stay the course. The process is the worst part of the process. I appreciate that. Somebody write that down for me.
That was good.
The process is the worst part of the process. Because the worst part of the process, I'm done. Knock me out. The hardest part about the process is that you are literally stagnant, seeing what you want, but seeing how far it's going to take you to get there. And you feel like you have the ability to get there, but it's everything in you that you don't see that's telling you you can't. And it's not telling you can't because you're incapable. It's telling you it can't because it's not your time.
Yeah. Rush the process.
My wife was cooking mashed potatoes the other day, and she was like, you know what? The part, you got to skin the potatoes, you got to put it in a boil, and it has to boil till it gets soft. Some of us want to come out after being in a boiler for 5 minutes. It takes longer than that. You got to get right. You got to get ready. And you're seeing it, I understand. That's the thing I hate about, we see so much. And don't see enough at the same time. We see the stadiums. Listen. When I heard that Carter Buford was making $1 million to play for Dave Matthews Band, I almost fell out because I just can't imagine that kind of money. I want that money right now.
Yes, sir.
Go Dave Matthews Band. Put that in your phone. Y'all go figure out who Dave Matthews Band is. Found out who Dave Matthews. Come on, young people. Listen, I'm trying to help y'all. This don't mean nothing. This is easy. This is the easy part. They're not telling you this because they don't want you to know. Because once you know, they're out of business. If you notice the same people working all the time, it ain't you because they don't want you to know. They pass down who they want to know. And then they going to keep it a secret. And then they will tell us the next person who they know, and it keeps a loyalty factor so that only the three of them work that section of the industry. And they black. We can name off the six drummers who are all on arena gigs right now. And I guarantee you, each one of them have another gig lined up as soon as they get off the road. And we want to play the fastest chops? No. I promise you, it's dope though. It's good to have, because when they give you the solo, you want to take off and smash. That's what you want. But at the end of the day, your bank account, you being a gold preferred status with Bank of America, and you having annuities, and you having cash to do whatever you want, that's what you want. You want the Nissan Stewart mailbox money that gives you $500,000 just to go to the bank. Yeah, Nissan Stewart did, oops, there goes my skirt, up over my head, he made that track. You know what? Every 3 months he was getting six-figure checks in his mailbox. For one track that he made, Eric Seitz, he made the Rock the Boat track. He said he was seeing $1 million in the mailbox. Thank God that it happened that way for him. He sent $1 million in the mailbox. Who knows, who can name me four people Eric Seitz have ever played for? Who can name me five people Nissan Stewart plays for, or played for? Nissan Stewart on TV right now. Y'all see what I'm trying to say? Trust me, I'm gonna play a good little chop, and then I'm gonna go home. We gonna share for a couple minutes. We get my wife home. She gonna kill me, and I can't stop talking. But this right here is where God just has me kind of pouring into y'all, because at the end of the day, I was one of the lucky ones to get the blueprint. I was one of the lucky ones to get the blueprint. We try and play drums. We don't want to write songs. We try to play drums. We don't even want to know who the pioneers are. We don't want to talk about Joe Smith. We don't want to talk about Bill Maxwell. And if it wasn't for them, you wouldn't have Terry Baker and Calvin Rogers and Joe Smith and Teddy Campbell. Y'all laughing at Teddy? Because he cheated on his wife? He going to the bank on y'all. He going to the bank on y'all. And he playing four shows a year, getting six figures. And not $100,000, like $300,000 to play for Ricky Minor. Y'all know who Ricky Minor is, right?
Yes, sir.
I mean, I get it. We all have the aspirations. I promise this is the end of it. We all have the aspirations to record. I challenge all of you, not only to create your sound, not only to focus on the pattern, the pocket, the paper, but look deeper into the opportunities that you can gain from being a musician. It goes far beyond playing Ratty McHugh's flam taps, good cymbals, and shouting beats. Trust me when I tell you, it goes far beyond that. I'll be honest, a dream of mine is to MD The Tonight Show. That's a dream that I have. It don't even matter for me. At first it was Jay Leno. That ain't happening, obviously. Maybe he'll come back. He'll be like the old Johnny Carson. Maybe. Who knows? But I wrote that down. I talked to God about it in my prayer time. In the 4 years, I met Kevin Eubanks.
Wow.
And I said to him, listen, I don't want to play no music. I want to sit down and I want to talk to you, because what you've done is my dream. He said, okay. We went out to eat. He put out his wallet. I said, no, on me. And I barely had $350
in it. I barely had $350 in the account. Barely. But that's an investment. Because he sees in me what I saw in him a long, long time ago. And don't get me wrong,
Don't get me wrong, I mean, Chris Love and the Naked Bay.
Yeah.
In the Escalade, like,
sir.
Good God Almighty. Like, God, like, they gotta be pulling 2-3 mil a season. A piece.
Yeah, easy.
Do you know what you can do with like $6 million? That's just one income. That's one income. $6 million is coming. But we wanna, and this is not bad, but we wanna spend our earnings to go to convocation and eat and hang out with girls and raise our body count. That ain't getting you no gig, bro.
Well.
Playing for the choir ain't getting you no gig. No matter how many times you put it on your Facebook, no matter how many times you put it on your Instagram, it ain't going to pay off the way you want it to.
That's right.
It ain't going to pay off. I was the guy doing it. I know. I went to GMWA for free 2 years back to back. Trying to get on. Staying in the room with two people. It, there's two beds. Somebody got to sleep on the floor. Because I ain't sharing no bed with no grown man. No, no, sir. Especially. You did. I didn't say that. You did. I didn't say it. No way I said that. I didn't say it. He said it. Now, please hear my heart, though, guys. Please hear my heart. We are, I think, I believe that God has given me a gift to be a seer. To be a seer, to see, not necessarily a prophet. I don't want to claim that, but I think God's given me a gift to be a seer. What I see is there's going to be a time very soon where it's going to be a changing of the guards in the music industry. Very, very soon. Very, very soon, there's going to be a change in the guard in the industry, and it's up to us.
Yeah.
Actually, it's a lot. It's up to us to influence you all to be a part of the change, not to be in the crowd, but to be leaders of the change.
Yeah.
It's good, Brandon.
Come on. I mean, the change is going to come. It's happening now. It's happening now. Some of us can't see it. I can see it clear as day. It's happening now. And I want all of you all, the best payoff of all time is for all of us to be there at the Grammys in 10, 20, 30 years, like, dog, we made it. I listened to what was deposited in me, and I did it. And you don't gotta be nominated for a Grammy. Just be there playing.
Yeah.
Be invited. Be hanging with people that got Grammy associations. Y'all hanging with people that just want, you know. I mean, it's cool. Trust me, it's cool. But time out for the mediocre lifestyle of just playing drums at church on Sundays, because it's not going to pay your bills.
No.
Trust me. I was living with my parents before I got married. I moved out, rude awakening.
Yeah.
It's real. Because that first is coming.
Huh?
And the 15th is coming right after the first.
Next week.
It ain't the second, you, be on the second, third, and fourth. You're going to be going to call your parents like, Mom, I need to get back in the basement. It ain't happening the way I thought it was.
Next week.
That's what, I really can't say enough. Thank you. And I was telling Hutchins.
Darius.
I was telling him, me and my wife, we just went through that process.
Mm-hmm.
I just had a conversation. Tell God what you want. Tell God what you want. He will answer with what you need. I prayed for my wife specifically because I was depressed with my last breakup. And I said, God, I want X, 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 X. To the point that things that I left out, she don't have. And I thought that I could live with that. I thought I could live without it. I'm living with it, and I'm the happiest man I've ever been.
I know what you mean.
Because I told God what I want. Get in a place where you and God have a conversation. You don't got to speak in tongues. You don't got to fall out. Just talk to him. Convo. God, this is what my desire is. I know my desire don't really matter to you, but my desire is this. My desire is this. And if it be your will, let this come to fruition for me so I can do your will in my life. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You feel me? Because at that point, he'll reveal himself. He'll reveal himself. When I graduated college, I didn't have a savings account. I didn't have life insurance. I didn't have health insurance. I didn't have dental insurance. I lied. I had it on my parents. When I got to the age of 25, it all fell to the ground. You on your own. So what I do, I went to my father. My father's a pastor. I'm blessed. Don't even know I'm blessed. Father's pastor said, Pops, I need something. He said, be my minister of music. I said, okay. Now, I'm dedicated to my church. I got to be in my church. But I told my father, I told my pastor what my dreams were. I told my pastor what my dreams were. So my pastor was like, okay, this is your dream? That means that you have to be accountable to that man at all times. And that man is accountable to God for you. So when you get calls to fulfill the dreams that you want, he ain't shocked. He's like, I know. And sometimes, and Matt was like, don't be that guy that, you get a gig and you call out the day before. If you get a call to go out with Bruno Mars, call everybody and tell them, I'm not coming home.
Yes, sir.
See you when I see you. You hear me? I'm gone first. But make sure your light is shining.
Yeah, right. Yeah, man.
Some of us don't have them gigs because our light ain't shining. My first tour, sitting on the table, and these gentlemen were talking about doing a line of coke right in front of me. A line of cocaine right in front of me, as if it skills.
Right.
Yeah, man, I got the coke. I don't think it's time that we go ahead and start. How many of us would have fell into that temptation?
Was that a gospel tour?
No. You want to talk about the gospel tours? We can talk about the gospel tours. Yo, bro, what you doing after this? We going to the bar, and I got my shorties coming through.
All my homies.
Oh, God.
I mean, we just got done kicking up a sign. We just got done doing this. We going to the bar, and they going to come to the hotel afterwards. You down? You gay?
It's true.
And they married.
Wow.
And they married. And they people who you look up to.
Yup.
That's it.
What you going to do when you playing for that artist and got your check on time?
That's it right there.
Boys just got off a tour. They got lowballed and they didn't get paid on time. Lowballed and on time? You do that to me, I gotta kill you. I got to. I'll break your legs or something. What? I'm taking a symbol off, I'm slicing. Slicing. You know what I mean? I hope, long story short, that what I've said has inspired you all to look deeper into your passion.
300 people.
Because your passion is what is going to propel God's work through you.
Yes, sir.
Your passion is what God uses your gift. He anoints you to be passionate about something, and your gift comes out of your passion. Y'all feel, does that make sense what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's good, man.
You know what I'm saying? So my prayer is that God really Man, Justin, that preach thing is just on me today. I don't know why it's on me so hard. But I just feel there's something in this room that has the power to go beyond. Yeah. Tap into it. Because y'all got examples. I mean, Junebug wrote a song. Come on now. Y'all didn't know that man's song was on Apostle Harry Murray's record. And y'all think it's a joke. I mean, not being funny, we've laughed at some of the people that we see. Uh-huh. Who knows that man can give you life insurance? Uh-huh. That man can help you with your finance.
Yep.
Oh, I ain't playing for them. Ain't. $75 gig. Go do that $75 gig if God is telling you to do it. Get yourself off of the sin, put it in church. Do that job for real. But, you know what I'm saying? And I'm sure Justin's been in, I'm sure we all been in situations where it's like, yo, like, this don't make no sense. Like, when we first started, when I first started playing for JJ, it didn't make sense.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I said it didn't make sense to me. Like, dog, I'm worth more than this.
Mm-hmm.
What if I would have aborted the mission?
Right.
Just think, I think about that constantly. What if I would have aborted the mission of not staying the course that God had for me? I wouldn't be a Grammy-nominated producer. That don't matter, but it matters to some people. Because now my rate has gone up. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So now if someone be like, yeah, dog, can you produce this song for me? I'm like, sure. You got your money?
Yeah, that's right.
What's the deposit? The deposit is X. If you don't got a deposit, I ain't starting jack. Because now I can demand that.
Yeah.
Because the process has allowed me to. Pattern, pocket, paper, process. Pattern, pocket, paper, process. It's all you need to accomplish what you want to accomplish. That's all you need. Pattern, pocket, paper, process. I promise you, you'll see the highest of highs. Sometimes you'll see the lowest lows. Sometimes. But you'll be in the wheel. Thank y'all. Yeah, you got a question?
Yeah. First of all, seriously, I appreciate everything you've been talking about and everything.
Sure.
I have our conversations and all that. You know, it's well deserved everything you have. Now, the pattern, pocket, process. If it's not too late, can I hear that pattern from that song?
the blood joint. All right, I'll play that song all the way through. And then, yeah. Let's talk about it. Because I didn't see purpose in it. It's another P word. Jesus, stop talking. Because I didn't see purpose in it. I went to Berkeley because I wanted to be a success. And the list of musicians who go to Berkeley. It's like, if you go to Berkeley, success is like kind of stamped on you.
Yeah.
Which goes back to what I'm saying. You want to do something, follow the blueprint of people who have done it. You know what I mean? Not be them, look into the blueprint of what they did. Education, you can copy anybody's education. School was educational for me. I thought that I was ready to go out and be on a tour. And if I be honest, my two roommates, who are my closest two best friends, stabbed me in the back to go get on a tour that I was originally called for. So at that point, I was at my lowest point in life, where I was like, yo, this is purposeless. Let me go home. I can go. It was almost like I was like the children of Israel in the wilderness, and I was telling my parents, slavery was better than this.
Wow.
I might as well go back to captivity.
Wow.
You know what I mean? That's how I felt. I might as well go back to captivity. At least I know what the routine will be.
Yeah.
I live with my parents. I don't need to go far. I play drums in my church. I'm making $450 a week playing drums in my church. That'll sustain me. My mortgage a month ain't $450 a week for 4 weeks. It ain't that. You know what I mean? I live in D.C. Cost of living is three times what it is here. That's why if somebody had a three-bedroom house for $1,100, I wish in D.C.
Coming to New York.
Oh, that's not even a studio. $1,100, that ain't even a studio in New York. So, answer your question. I wanted to quit school because I didn't see the immediate dividend of return for what I was doing. You know what I'm saying? And it felt like all my friends who had came in with me, who promised me that they would be in the trenches with me, had all deserted me. Some of it was my fault. I admit that. But being stabbed in the back, I didn't think that was worth it. Never. So that's why I wanted to leave school. Best decision of my life, besides marrying my wife and accepting Jesus Christ, was staying in school. Had I not stayed in school, I would have not gained the knowledge that I know. I mean, Kevin Eubanks, John Roberts, Quincy Jones, Lil Jon Robinson, Layla Hathaway, John Blackwell, John Mayer, all these people who I met and hung with, had time with while I was at school. Me and my wife had came to visit me at the time I was in school. When Whitney Houston died in February, her MD called me and was like, come get me. I don't know what to do with myself. The woman's MD, teaching at Berkeley, Jethro Da Silva, called me and was like, come get me. I don't know what to do with myself. It was a purpose in me being there.
Yeah.
And that man knew God. That man knows God. He preached in God's church. But when he hit a place that hurt him deeply, what if he didn't have nobody? You know what I mean? If I'm lying, I'm flying. My wife, right there, she was with me. We ended up going to Cheesecake Factory and sitting there for 5 hours. We ordered twice. I made him pay for that bill that day. You know what I mean? And it was just God. I mean, we played Sly and Family Stone. We did a whole medley of Sly and Family Stone music. Stuff I've never heard before. You know what I'm saying? Music I'd never heard before. I mean, we got on a list. I mean, crazy. So, any other questions before I play this song? Yes, that's it. Any other questions? I'm not playing. Yes, sir.
I'm late. Did you talk about getting
endorsed? I can't talk about it. I didn't talk about it, but I can.
It's like everybody wants to get endorsed with their
kids. Yep. That's real.
Please tell
them. Yeah, okay, so, an endorsement is a business agreement between you and a company. The business agreement that you will bring them revenue. That is an endorsement. That is an endorsement. Now, they have qualifications to how you bring them revenue. Either one, you're working, two, you're a rep, or three, you're buying it yourself. Either one, you're working, two, you're repping, or three, you're buying it yourself. Now, the kid that I played on tour with Daughtry, the gross amount of that whole kid, cymbals, drum heads, drums, pedal sticks, was over $13,000. And I'm only playing one up to now in six cymbals. Yep. I'm playing 12, 16, 18. The qualifications for you getting in this business agreement with them is you have to have a gig. Or you have to have a mass amount of following that they think you and what you do will help people to come and buy their stuff at full price. So I'll give you an example. Who has a phone out? Are you? Please, nobody record this. Eric Moore is an example of. Eric Moore is an example of someone who doesn't necessarily have a game, but he has influence. He has influence. Eric Moore is a fantastic player. He has influence. He has like 200,000, 300,000 followers on his Instagram. So when he plays a video, he's getting millions and quadrillions of likes. That's what the company wants to see. How many of us have 2,000 followers in here? 5,000 followers? 7,000 followers? 10,000 followers? And the hands go down. And that man has hundreds of thousands of followers. So, once, now, there are ways that you can get the endorsement. Let me make this fast. There are ways that you can get this endorsement. You go to the company and you say, listen, I want to endorse you and play this product while I'm out on this road. Okay, I want to play this product, period. They respond back and say, thank you. Fill out this paper. That paper asks you, what are you doing? Who are you doing it with? How many times are y'all doing it? Meaning, who are you gigging with? Where are y'all going? How many dates do y'all have? You can put New Community Church of God of Christ if you want. They're going to laugh at you and throw your whole thing in the trash. They're going to laugh. Now, how many people here have an EPK? None of us can get endorsed. How many have resumes? Quite a few of us are half the way there. Get an EPK. Show them what you're doing, who you're doing it with. Now, please don't only put like your church choir or like you playing at church on Sunday. Let me be honest. These companies don't want the black people because they all play chops. They don't want you because you play chops. They don't want you. They already have Aaron and Gerald.
Yep.
They don't want you. And we, the black people, the black youngins, carry this stigma that all we gonna do is ask them for free equipment and not bring them no revenue.
Bad stigma.
We gonna be like, ooh, let me get this new snare. Ooh, let me get this new kit. Let me get the 18, 12, 16, 14, 13. Let me get this new snare. And then 22 and 24 bass drum with an 18 too. And they be like, cool. Be like, can you send it to me for free? Nah, geez. That's gonna be $6,000. Give me $6,000. So, the drums are the hardest to get. Sticks a second. It's all depending on what you're doing. If you're not doing a major gig at this point, don't call them. Don't call them. The best thing for you to do is establish a relationship with you and the A&R. Mm-hmm. Hi, my name is Brandon. I don't want anything from you. I just want to let you know how much I enjoy playing your equipment. This equipment makes me sound like the best me that I can be, and it is propelling me to great and higher points. I don't want an endorsement from you. I just want to say thank you for being the best company in the world. Period. Have a great day. Bye-bye. That gets you a foot in the door. I'll be honest. I was blessed. I'm not going to lie to you. I met John Blackwell. John Blackwell helped me play drums. He said, what are you doing tomorrow? I said, nothing. He said, be in this Berkeley lobby at 9 a.m. in the morning. Now, I told y'all before, I don't like doing anything before 10. John Blackwell, the late, great John Blackwell, said, be in this lobby at 9. Guess what time I was in that lobby? I was sitting, looking at the doors at 8:25 like this. Waiting. He ain't get there until 9:30. You think I said anything to him about being late? Nope. Mind you, I really didn't know where we were going. I said, John, where are we going? We're going to the Zildjian factory. I said, huh? You going to the Zildjian factory, bruh? You ever been there before? No. Okay, cool. walks me inside, introduces me to the A&R. I met Craigie and Debbie Zildjian, everybody. I mean, they got Buddy Rich kids sitting up. They got Dennis Chambers kids sitting. I mean, it's a thing. I mean, and then Sabian, who is Satan's sister, is down the street. Right down the street. Yamaha's Lucifer's daughter is around there as well. But I'm just kidding, y'all. But that is the process. Now, after you've established relationship, hey, it's Johnny. I don't want anything, I just want to say Merry Christmas. Hope you and your family had a fantastic Christmas. Thank you, have a blessed day. Don't talk about drums. They get 50,000 people talking to them about drums every day. Be the difference. Make a relationship with them. Then when you aspire to go to NAMM, hey, I'm Johnny. I've been sending you the emails. Johnny, nice to meet you. Have you looked at our new equipment? Actually, I have. It's fantastic. You don't gotta see it. Just tell them it's good. Tell them it's fantastic. It's incredible. Oh my God, I played this new Crash. Oh my God, like, how did y'all think about that? But actually know what you're talking about, because they do. Yeah. Don't be talking about that. Yeah, you know, the color is just, and the K is perfect. Don't do that. Don't do that. Talk about the decay. Talk about the bell. Talk about the body. Talk about the sound of the cymbal. Why do you like the cymbal? Do you have innovative ideas? Talk about the ride. I like the body of the ride. It sizzles a little too much for me. Do you have something that has a little less cymbal and a little more body? Yeah, I do. Can I see that? I like the 16, but it's a little too thin. You got a 17? Maybe an 18? Don't be like one of my friends did. Go to the Zildjian booth and be like, man, y'all EFX is good, but Sabian, that ozone is just... I just looked at him like, hope you enjoyed it. It's over for you. And I didn't walk him in either. I was like, you're gonna do this on your own. Because imagine what I would have looked like, and that guy's at the Zildjian factory somehow, or at the Zildjian booth, like, this is great, but the ozone is like the pioneer of cymbals with the holes in it. And Zildjian had a remix in 96. So that's how the endorsements happen. Cool? Make sense? Alright, let me play this song. And then can we share after that? Or is it share later? Pastor, Pastor, I'm so sorry. I'm gonna wait over my time. Forgive me. I'm a silent pastor. We talk a lot. I'm sorry. So blood of Jesus is a pattern. The pattern I was talking to you about earlier. You look like Sean Wright. Oh my God. You look like Sean Wright. Jesus. Oh man. That's my homie. I went to school together. That's my homie. And me, Sean Wright, DJ, Matt Gosker, we all shared it together. JT, Justin Tyson's playing for Robert Glasper now. Check him out. He's next level. Chris. Yeah, I do keep him. You know, Nick Swift is on his production game, man. He's killing the production. He's one of those guys, he came into Berkeley, knew what he wanted, and went after. He was an MPE major, which is music production and engineering, and that's what he wanted to do, and he was dead serious about it. That's what he did. But all of us, we all went to school together, so it's really cool to see how we all have kind of matriculated to where we are. And I wish those guys all the best. Chris Coleman came to the school one time, and all of us were in a shed with him, and he tore all of us up by himself. Chris Coleman is the greatest drummer alive right now. Y'all know who Chris Coleman is, right? Okay. Hey, man, I got to ask these questions. All right, so Brandon, pattern of this song, briefly, I'm from D.C., so we had this thing called Go-Go, right? Y'all know what Go-Go is? Brief history on Go-Go. The reason why it's called Go-Go is because the same beat keeps going and going and going. That's why it's called Go-Go. All right? Unfortunately, Jill Scott, do you want it? Oh, yeah, right. That's not Go-Go. That's not Go-Go. It's an attempt at it. Yeah. And unfortunately, not even being funny, victory is not Go-Go. It's their interpretation of it, which is cool, which is dope. I mean, I love Ty Tribbett Soundcheck. I'm a huge fan. So, Go-Go has kind of, and shout out to Paul Buggy Edwards, who for me is like the number one Go-Go drummer in the world right now. He just did a video talking about Go-Go. Y'all go check that out. He's the guy right now who is way above in Go-Go. Yep. And honestly, if you go to a Go-Go, which I encourage, if you go, don't go alone and go with someone who's from D.C. Do not go to a Go-Go alone, okay? It's not the safest environment ever, and it's not a musical experience whatsoever, okay? It is a sinful den of thieves, but it's really good music, okay? The original Go-Go beat is... Right? Go-Go has kind of gone a little further than that to this thing that we call the bounce beat in Go-Go. Yeah, which puts everything on a bounce, on a down leg. The Blood of Jesus is a bounce beat inside of a Motown-esque approach to Myron Butler's, My Brother Levi's, I Know It Was the Blood, with the Blood of Jesus. Okay? So the Blood of Jesus, which is on Charles' record, was recorded one time before by Myron Butler and Levi, produced by Spud, and which is killing. I mean, they smashed that. But as I said, gospel music has getting redundant. So if you're going to do gospel music, go. And if you're going to recreate a song, like let's say that you're going to put like How Great Is Our God on a record that you're producing or recording, I just really encourage you to sit down at a keyboard or sit down in some time with God and let God just kind of give you the direction of that song. Okay, so this is the Blood of Jesus. So in the verses, we created this pattern. Morgan and I, Morgan MD'd that record, I produced that record, and we wanted it to be different. So we kind of start, well, the chorus is like this really Motown kind of hip thing, like James Jamerson in the Attic kind of a chorus. But that's Motown, you know what I'm saying? Like, reach out. Y'all know that song, right?
Mm-hmm. Four times.
Well, dang it. That's a musician right there. Four times. All right. Or, if you're not really hip to the Motown era, you're a drummer or a bass player, you're way behind. You're way behind. For bass players, James Jamerson is kind of one of your things for a drummer, whoever played drums on those, because we really don't know at this point. There's so many different ones, we just don't know. All right, so that's kind of what it is. All right, so when we get to the verse, I know it, I see it. So just don't talk about this earlier. So the beat or the pattern is based off the anticipation of the groove. So the groove, one. Okay, do y'all everybody know what anticipations are? Anticipations, for everyone who doesn't know, anticipation is like a hit that comes before the downbeat, if I can just explain it in poor man's terms. It's a hit that comes before the downbeat. So an anticipation would be something like this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One. So that snare beat is an anticipation. All right, which most anticipations happen on ups, which are like eighth notes. One and two and three and four. One and two and three and four. Okay. Am I going too fast? Okay. Upbeats, which are anticipations. Upbeats are the and of your eighth notes. So one and two and three and four and one and two and. Eighth notes are one and two and three and four and. Quarter notes are one, two, three, four. One, two, three, anticipation. I'm sorry, one. Eighth notes will go like this. So this song, the beat is the derivative of the anticipation. So I know it was a bug. I hear the anticipations. Alright, so those are anticipations. Okay? I know I went through that really, 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 really fast. But your quarter notes? Eighth notes. Anticipations. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Okay? Now, drummers, let me just say this shameful plug. If you're playing chops and you're not catching the one, you're fired.
Fired. Automatic.
If you're grazing the one, if you're not catching, if grazing is bad too. The goal is to on the, okay? Amen? All right, just want to put that out there. We should be playing the one, okay? Cool, so that's the derivative of the song. Let me play it. If we have any questions, I'll really, really brief answers. Okay, here we go. stick fall.
It happens. It's just all right.
All right, so that's the song. One thing I didn't talk about, that bridge is very Marvin McQuitty. Y'all know who Marvin McQuitty is. For him in live in Las Vegas is like, to me, one of the greatest live experiences ever. If you're a drummer and a bass player, you haven't seen that, go watch that. Marriage between Maurice and Marvin is love. All right. But yeah, that's the whole song in general. A lot of those, my production is very intentional. So a lot of those random hits that you may feel are random, listen to the bass, listen to the keyboards. I'm playing it with along with them, which is something that I learned from Aaron Spears and the Fro, Funk Rock Orchestra. Everybody knows who that is, right? Y'all know who the Funk Rock Orchestra is? Who is the Funk Rock Orchestra? Huh? Okay, cool. It's Buddy Strong, Valdez, Natural, and Aaron. Aaron will be playing a lot of chops and stuff. But if you really, really, really listen in the background, there's Buddy playing stabs. It's always in there. So it's kind of something that I stole from them, or that I take from them to put into my production, all right? So that's that. Any questions? Any questions? All right, cool. Guys, thank you. Cool. I wish you would have did that except the stick flying. I don't know if it would happen. Guys, thank you again for having me. I hope you had a good time. I wish I could have played more, but it's in my heart to kind of inspire and speak. So my playing is very lackluster to me. But what I've experienced, I feel like can propel you to your next generation. I feel like Justin, like, I'm not that sweet. It's all a mystery. You know what I'm saying? I'm playing the same stuff over and over again. But thank you, AJ. Thank you again. I look forward to seeing y'all next year.